Before we go tonight, this weekend I traveled to Charleston, South Carolina, to the Circular Congregational Church for a town hall meeting on race. We were just blocks away from Emmanuel AME Church, where 9 black worshipers attending Bible study were gunned down in June. We spoke with local residents and national experts and activists about grief, recovery, the Confederate flag, and whether Black Lives Matter. In a PBS NewsHour Marist poll conducted last week before the town hall, we found widespread agreement about the scope of the problem. 60% of whites and 56% of blacks say race relations have gotten worse in the past year. But when we asked if African Americans and whites have the same job opportunities, for example, 76% of black respondents said no, they don't, while 52% of whites said yes, they do. And when we asked whether the police treat blacks and whites equally, 8% of African Americans said yes, compared to 42% of whites. At the town hall, I asked Ume Salah, who founded a group called the Dream Defenders after Trayvon Martin was killed in Florida in 2012, whether anything has changed.
What we've learned in the past year is not that black lives matter, but black deaths matter. That's the only time people wake up. That's the only time people react. But in South Carolina and around the country, if the politicians who were touting that Black Lives Matter really cared, there would be health care for black families so they could provide for better qualities of living. There would be quality education in the schools if you really cared about black lives. There wouldn't be mass incarceration if you really cared about black lives.
You can watch America After Charleston in full tonight at 9 p.m. Eastern on most PBS stations. It'll also be streaming live on our homepage. You can also find